Dingy and Dougie, they were talking behind the building.
So, who is this Dougie person?
Oh, I'm sorry. Doug Swallow. We were dating until about 8 months ago.
So, what were Doug, Mr. Swallow and Mr. Wright talking about anyway?
How can you be so mean? I would never eavesdrop. I wasn't raised to be so rude and unrefined.
That's right, Miss Spade. Don't drag the witness down to your level.
Why am I being nasty?
Please go on. What did you see next?
Then suddenly, Ducky got a wobble.
Are you saying that the victim just collapsed on his own?
Yes.
In other words, the defendant never touched the victim. Is that right?
I was watching the whole time. He never did a thing to Dougie.
I press for no good reason. Just know the judge will get angry with me.
So what should I do about her testimony just now?
There's no real contradiction, because the felon has already could hypothetically have crushed his umbrella. I'll leave it alone for now.
I suppose the statement works in our favor for now. I'll hold off on looking into any deeper until it's necessary.
Very well, young lady. Please get on with your testimony.
Okay. No, not that. Load it.
And what did Mr. Wright say when he saw you? Sorry, I was so flustered that I really don't remember. Please forgive me.
You don't remember?
Well, that's common enough. Sometimes I can't recall a sentence I passed only minutes prior.
Please, someone,
stop him before he gets hurt.
By me!
Okay.
When you say students, do you mean students from the thought department?
No, from the pharmacology department. The fuck department's on the other side of the schools. They're all very fond of their drugs.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Please try to stay on topic.
No. This isn't Arizona. Actually, Arizona voted against it, didn't they?
So, to find some pharmacology students, you went to the labs, correct? That's why I was playing you. But in the end, I wound up not going. About 10 research students came running out of the building entrance. Somehow they all seemed to know what was going on.
The students knew what was going on.
Sure.
But how could the students have known what was going on? Well, I don't know for sure that they knew what happened. It's just they all seemed kind of excited about something.
Doesn't look like I'm going to get any more info about the students.
So did the students call the police?
Yes, I'm so panicked.
Yes, and anyone would have been, my dear.
She's telling a super obvious lie, and she knows it. She's just pretending to protect Mr. Wright. Yes, that's gotta be it. Way to go, Mia.
Okay, that means I'm going to have to dig deeper to find contradictions in this one.
Okay, let's go take a look here.
Interesting. Alright. Not important. Let's give this one. I'm gonna call horseshit.
So, it's clear that they want me to call horseshit on this one, because Phoenix is just like, oh yeah, I pushed him. Let's contradict it.
Feeble lies are not very becoming, Miss Hawthorne, so let's drop them, shall we? What? I would never...
Attention! Mrs. Fay, I will not allow you to badger this witness. I believe the defense is engaged in a fishing expedition. That is...
she has no supporting... Please don't glance at me like that. I'm just doing my job. See, this is why it's... There should be a game with me instead of Phoenix. It's more fun to be on, like, the beating end. Phoenix just gets constantly shit on all the time. Having me is just, like, the complete opposite. She can glare at everybody. It's funnier. Because Phoenix couldn't do that. You just glare at somebody and they'd be like... Are you fucking gay? They're like, they just say something weird like that and just completely throw them off guard. Maya doesn't get like that, usually. I mean, sometimes she gets like that. She has a funny personality. I like Maya a lot. It's a shame. They had to kill her off in case two of the first game. Now then, Miss Hawthorne. The defendant's palm print was found in Mr. Swallow's leather jacket. It has already been shown Mr. Wright did, in fact, push the victim.
What?
There's no need to try to cover for the defendant. It would be much better if he came out and told us the whole truth.
There's nothing to worry about, young lady. Just tell us everything you saw.
Yes, Your Honor. I will. If you don't mind, I'd like to revise my testimony.
Also, if you'd really like, I could get the bug spray and kill those butterflies flying around you.
Yeah, that would probably be for the best.
We're finally getting somewhere. Actually, I didn't see the moment he pushed Dougie.
Okay.
You didn't see it.
Well, I saw the moment when Dougie fell to the ground.
And at that time, there were only two of them at the scene. The defendant, Phoenix Wright, and the victim, Doug Swallow.
Yes, that's right. It didn't look like they were fighting, and they didn't hear any noises either.
Okay. Let's press this one. Wait, you didn't hear any noises? Bullshit, you didn't hear any noises.
So then, what did it look like they were doing to you? I thought they were having a nice, friendly afternoon conversation.
Oh, give me a break.
That's why I really need to watch them all that closely.
Did you notice anything out of the ordinary at all?
No, nothing at all. Mr. Judge.
Oh, I like the sound of that. Mr. Judge. Now then, please proceed with your testimony.
I found some other students and they called the authorities. Let's call back to that one. Yeah, that's a major bullshitter. That works. Boom!
The witness testimony just now is clearly contradictory, Your Honor.
It could be.
It has to be, right? I knew it!
However, your evidence doesn't show what contradiction you think you see. Objection overruled. Try to think it over again.
Well, shit, I guess that wasn't a loud noise.
Well, there goes a few points with the judge.
Alright. Let's try that one again. I know this is the point. This is the point I need to press on. Okay, that was it. It's just the testimony, not the umbrella. Well, the umbrella should have worked, too.
You say you didn't hear any noise. Is that correct?
Well, I guess I'm not getting a perfect.
Yes, that's why I was very relaxed. Looking at the scenery all around me. That's nice. But I find it just a little odd. I have here the testimony of your boyfriend, Mr. Phoenix Wright. And he clearly testified to the effect that when he pushed the victim, he heard a sharp, loud noise.
He said that.
If you were really that close to the two of them, why didn't you hear this noise as well?
Ooh.
Well, maybe the noise just wasn't all that memorable. But according to Mr. Bird's testimony, it was a sharp noise like a snap!
Mrs. Wright, Mrs. Mia, where did that noise come from?
Oh. Sorry, Mr. Grossberg.
No. There's no way a noise like that could fail to make an impression.
May I have a moment to answer?
By all means.
I know the reason why I didn't hear the noise. You see, the truth is... I was listening to my beats! I had my... Oh my gosh, she did have headphones on! I had my headphones on, and I was listening to trap music at the time.
Headphones. Sorry, I keep messing up pains in the judge's voice.
Headphones? You mean that both of your ears were covered?
The ring was just beginning to let out, but it seemed as though Thor wasn't ready for his fun to come to an end yet. So the sky continued to flash and rumble.
Thunder and lightning, huh?
Yes, I'm afraid of the sound of thunder.
So I put my headphones on to block it out. Well, Your Honor, as you can see, there wasn't any contradiction in her testimony after all.
Wait a second, Mia. The testimony just now.
She said something that could totally change this whole case.
There was lightning. Let's think about this one for a second. Okay.
So, her not hearing anything isn't super important. It just means a loud snap. Her listening to music also doesn't mean anything. There was lightning.
Lightning could be important. Because it was thundering and lightning outside, the one idiot was holding an umbrella, which is fucking idiotic. Well, yeah, I'm going to go on that one. I've always been told not to wear an umbrella in a thunderstorm. In fact, not to go out during a thunderstorm, because that's also stupid.
Your Honor, there's a problem with the witness's testimony.
What do you mean?
Didn't you notice? She said there was lightning, correct?
Yes. What about it?
Well, lightning is actually a large discharge of electricity in the atmosphere. Am I right?
Now's not the time for a science lesson, Miss Faye.
Yes, Your Honor. Anyway, since the cause of death was electrocution...
Isn't it possible that the victim died from being hit by a bolt of lightning? I must admit that the thought had not occurred to me.
I must admit that thought had not occurred to me either. That's a 1 in 6,000 chance of that, Mia.
So what kind of thoughts do occur to this guy anyway? This entire case is built on the premise that Mr. Doug Swallow was murdered. But the very premise itself is mistaken. The defense believes that Mr. Swallow was, in fact, the victim of a stray boat.
I don't believe that in the slightest, but I'll take it, sure. Whatever extends the case longer.
It appears that the even slithered and maybe onto something. Could it be that the death was actually accidental?
I wouldn't even call that an accident. That's God's fault. Let's get God here. Hello there, I'm God.
God, did you strike it with a bolt of lightning?
No, it's actually a boy.
Oh. Why does my voice sound like yours? I don't know. Our voices just kind of switch up. I had a pretty cool sounding voice for a second there. Ah, understandable. Hey, do you want some Dr. Pepper? I love Dr. Pepper.
Anyway.
Alright, you did it, Mia. I'm taking that not guilty now as I...
I'm hurt that you have such a low opinion of me, Miss Faye. I'm not a fool, you know. The prosecution has done its research, Your Honor. We found that there were no lightning strikes on that day at that location.
But
what's more, we have evidence that the electrical cable is definitely linked to this case.
Evidence, Mr. Payne. What is this evidence?
This affidavit.
Affidavit? I don't even know what that means.
Hey, Alexa. What's an affidavit?
I wasn't able to understand the question I heard.
Alexa, what does affidavit mean?
Sorry, I can't find the answer to the question I heard.
Fucking sick, Alexa. Alexa, what does affidavit mean?
Sorry, I didn't understand.
Okay, time for this. A-F-F-I-D-A-V-A-T. I-T, I mean. A written statement confirmed by oath or affirmation for use as evidence in court. Okay, affirmative it. It's like affirmative and like, I don't know.
The pharmacology students who were conducting experiments in their labs that day, allow me to read out the court's in testimony of the pharmacology students. All equipment in the labs lost power all of a sudden at around 3 o'clock p.m. that day.
Was it a blackout?
All the labs equipment was on high voltage off.
So you're saying equipment lost power because...
Precisely.
They lost power because of the severed electrical cable. The power outage occurred at approximately 3 p.m.
Which fits with the time of death listed in the autopsy report.
Bullshit, man. Then it comes down to the fucking watch. We should have prevented that, like, presented the watch like 8 minutes ago. No, more like 30 minutes ago.
Exactly. In other words, the victim dies as a result of touching the severed electrical cable. According to the students, the cables were very old. They were planning on having them replaced in the near future.
I see.
Apparently, the cables had become so brittle that even the smallest bump would have caused them to break. Awkward.
However, there is one thing that troubles me.
If the cable could have been broken by any small bump, then it wouldn't have snapped if it had been bumped into, correct? Well, I suppose you could say that.
Miss Faye, do you have any thoughts regarding the cause of the severed cable?
Your Honor, I don't like how this is looking one bit. I have to come up with something to try and regain some momentum. If it pleases the court, the thief would like to state its opinion.
Well then, let's hear it. Who or what was it that caused the cable to break?
Let's take a look.
Makes logical sense. Doug Swallow caused the cable to break, right? I mean, this one doesn't actually hurt me, so I might as well try it. Yeah, it's Doug Swallow broke the cable.
This is it. This is why the cable snapped.
Well, Your Honor.
I believe the only thing that has snapped is the mind of the defense.
Ah, that was one of your best lines yet, Your Honor.
That was harsh.
Please, Your Honor, give me one more chance.
Well then, let's hear it.
Okay, I'm pretty sure it was him, but I guess not. Maybe I'm missing something totally stupid. Some sort of impact. What sort of impact? They didn't really say what sort of... I guess the umbrella?
Okay.
That was a bit of jumping logic. Alright. Let's just prevent, like, the student testimony. I guess that makes the most logical sense. Unless it just wants me to jump and start prosecuting her. No, that's another jumping shit. Let's just go with the student testimony.
Awkward. Can I, take a rain check on this one?
What caused the cable to snap? How did I miss this?
I do believe my mind has snapped on this one. Alexa, what am I forgetting?
can't find the answer to the question I heard.
You can't either, huh? Alright. Does it seriously just want me to jump on her? I don't want to jump on her. I also don't want to jump on Phoenix. That's counterintuitive. Okay, well, the cable broke at 255. Just jump on her. She snapped the cable. I don't know. This is seriously just want me to throw out Phoenix? Let's throw Phoenix under the bus. Because that's my last answer that makes any logical sense. Unless it wants me to prevent something stupid. Your Honor, please think back. Oh, really? We're just throwing Phoenix under the bus, huh? Alright.
Please think back to Mr. Wright's testimony.
The defendant's testimony.
He said that after he pushed the button, he heard a loud, sharp noise. Now, this happened at around 3 p.m., correct?
Yes, that sounds right. Wait, are you saying that...
The lab equipment lost power 255, which fits right in Mr. Wright's timeline. In other words, it was Mr. Wright's shove that caused the power outage.
Oh, that makes more sense. Oh, shit, I was thinking about that all wrong. Okay, so he shoved himself into the pole. Okay.
Yes, the prosecution also came to that same conclusion. And it was that very shove that caused his mom to be electrocuted.
Well, shit, I was jumping too hard on that.
I'm afraid I can't agree with you there, Mr. Payne.
What's that supposed to mean?
Take a good look at where he landed after being shoved. See the umbrella? It's by the electrical pole. That's right. The victim banged into the pole as a result of being pushed.
Well, this is harder than case two, or the case one trial two. Well, that was a brain fart. Good on me.
Well, that makes sense. And the victim was electrocuted.
Nope.
I'm sorry, Your Honor, but no, it doesn't make sense at all. If the victim was shoved into the far pole, then he couldn't have been electrocuted by the severed cable in the foreground here. In other words, someone other than my client must have electrocuted the victim.
Still leaping logic, but whatever.
Order! Order in the court!
Ah, the laminations of my enemy. How I've longed to hear them.
It's true. The defense is absolutely correct. There doesn't seem to be any way the defendant could have...
Mr. Judge, may I say something? Madame's attorney's explanation. She said some things that are a little different than I remember them.
What?
What the fuck?
Please, just once more. May I please testify one last time? Please, Mr. Judge.
Of course, it's all right. Just go right ahead and give your new testimony.
My foot is about to achieve maximum capacity in his ass! She's finally starting to show her true colors.
The truth is, Phoebe pushed him twice.
Twice?
The first time was into the electric pole. That's when the cable broke. Then Dougie tried his best to run away from him. But Phoebe caught up and crashed into him from behind. The cable snapping and Dougie being electrocuted. It all occurred in less than a minute.
Oh, fuck. Oh, alright. Let's break that one apart.